Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social This Side, and this is continuation of Power BI tutorial. So today we are going to discuss about data sources. So what is the data sources and how we can connect with the web? So let's move to next slide. So here, as we can see, we are having files, then database, then Power Platform, then Azure, then online services, after that others. So these are the main pillars available in the Power BI sources. So we can connect with these sources. So here I have noted down few databases where we can connect. So we can see we can connect with the SQL Server database. We can connect Access database, SQL Server Analysis Services database, Oracle database, IBM DB2 database. So these are the options available by which we can connect. Just move to Power BI and see in the practical. So let me open the Power BI desktop. So double click on this and we need to wait until it will not be going to open. It may take few seconds. So here, as I told you, don't log in at yet and cancel this. So this is the interface of the Power BI desktop, as I told you in the earlier. So here, as we can see in the get data option, so go to in home ribbon and here we are having get data. Just click on this. So mainly we are having Excel files and Power BI data sets, Power BI data flow, SQL Server, analysis services. So these are the options available by which we can get the data. Here, let me click on more. Once I click on more, we need to wait. So here we are having all file, database, Power Platform, Azure, online services and others, as I told you. So in the files, we can connect with the Excel file, we can connect with the CSV text file, we can connect with the XML file, JSON file, then folder, then PDF file and SharePoint folder. In the databases, as I told you, all these databases are available. We can connect any one of these. And here Power BI platform, so Power BI data set, Power BI data flows, then common data services, then Power Platform data flows. Then in the Azure services, we are having these options. Azure SQL Server, we can connect. Azure SQL Data Warehouse, we can connect. So these are the options available by which we can connect. In the online services, we can see all these options available by which we can connect. So here we can see Google Analytics and Adobe Analytics and Facebook. So we can connect all these options. Now go to on all and here let me search for the web. So let me open this web. So here we are having this web. Now click on connect. So once we click on connect, it will ask the URL. So go to on browser. So I am going to use Google Chrome. You may have another browsers. And here let me search for IMF World Economy Outlook database for December 2019. Just click on this. So latest data is available October 2019. So okay, here we can see we are having this data. So we can click on this. So latest October data we have. Now click on this. And here we can click on all countries. That looks great. Now click on continue. Once we click on continue, then here we can select the GDP. So we can connect with the gross domestic product current price for US dollar and click on continue. Once we click on continue, then it will ask the range. We just want to get data from 2K15 to 2K24. That is good. Then prepare report. It will take few seconds. So here we are having country, then subject, descriptor, units, scale and many other columns. And here we are having 2K15, 16, 17, 18, 19 up to 2024. So we just want to load this table in the Power BI desktop. So how we can? Just copy this URL and go to on Power BI and let me paste this URL over here. After that, click on OK. Once we click on OK, we need to wait few seconds. In the navigator, we can see this. So go to on Web View. So here we can see we are having this table 1. So we just want to get data only for this table 1. So we can select this table, and here we are having transform data or load. So once we load, it will be directly loaded into Power BI desktop. If we click on this transform data, then it will automatically open the query editor. So let me click on this transform data. So here, as we can see, we are having this Power Query editor. So if we want to change something, we can do over here. As of now, I don't want to change anything. So just close and apply. So here, as we can see, table 1 is loaded successfully over here. And if we want to build any report or any visualization, we can create via using this table 1's data. So this is how we can connect with the web, and we can load data from web to Power BI desktop. That's it for this video, and so thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much, guys.